Hello, welcome to this video. In case you're watching for the first time, I invite you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I believe you'll find some videos that you'll find inspiring and insightful. My name is Jesse Ainebiona. In this video, I would like to share with you about self-discipline. Self-discipline is absolutely critical and essential if we are going to achieve our goals. Jim Rohn, a renowned author and speaker, once said that discipline is the gap between goals and accomplishments. That means that if you want to achieve your goals, you certainly need discipline. In this video, I'm going to share with you three things that you can consider to get better in the area of self-discipline. The first is become a master of your feelings. Now, self-discipline is also described as the ability to get yourself to do what you should do, when you have to do it, whether you feel like or not. It has nothing to do with feelings. It is just about the fact that something has to be done, and regardless of how you feel, you get up and do it. It is much easier to act yourself into a feeling than to feel yourself into an action. That implies that if you have a project to do or an activity to do, when it is time to do it, regardless of how you feel, get up and get moving. The feelings will catch up with you. Because if we do things only when we feel like, we shall do and accomplish very little. So, number one, become a master of your feelings. The second thing that you can consider to get better in the area of self-discipline is find accountability. Find some people or somebody that can hold you accountable. Take for example, my wife and I are doing exercises together. So we walk regularly to exercise and keep fit. Sometimes we don't feel like doing it, but because we hold each other accountable, it has become easy for us to maintain it and be consistent. So in the same way, whatever you want to do, whether it is saving money or improving your personal development, find someone or a group of people that can hold you accountable to that goal. And the last thing I will mention is put in place limits. What do I mean by limits? I simply mean put in place parameters that are going to keep you from doing what you wouldn't want to do. So for instance, if you don't want to spend money just like that, rather than moving with a lot of money, why not move with little money? Because if you go with a lot of money to the mall, there is a high chance that you will spend it even when you had not planned to spend it. If you want to maintain a healthy diet, then don't buy junk because you can't eat junk food if you don't have it in the house. So put in place some limits and parameters to keep you on course so that you do not do the things that you don't want to do. So if we can master our feelings, find accountability and put in place limits, I believe that will take us a long way in mastering self-discipline. In closing, I want to say that discipline is not easy. It will come at a price. But remember, in life, we shall always have to either face the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. Now, the pain of discipline weighs grams, but the pain of regret weighs tons. Would you rather pay the pain of discipline or face the pain of regret? I will invite you, pay the price of discipline. Then your goals and dreams will become realistic for you to achieve. Thank you for watching. And again, I invite you, subscribe to my YouTube channel for more uplifting and inspiring videos. Thank you and see you in the next video.